So we've got the sales sheet completed, and what we want now is a costs sheet. So these are things that the theatre has to spend money on. So I'm just going to create a new one. I'm just going to rename it costs. And in order to sell these things, we have to buy them in the first place, and that's going to cost money. So I'm just going to copy those, and I'm going to paste them into costs. Okay, because these will cost us money. Okay, so I'm going to put some headings: cost to theatre, number bought, and total cost. Okay, call that item. It's up into a little table, and then I'll just double tap, click in there. Just to format it so we can see what's going on. Okay, so this is things that we as the theatre are spending money on in order so that we can sell them to customers in this tab here. Okay, so we'll say let's say drinks cost 0.3, drinks 0.5, crisps 0.5, and maybe programs, I can't remember how much. We're selling programs for £5. We say like programs cost £2. Okay, and as you can see there, the formatting isn't quite right because we don't have the pounds. So if you remember, we highlight, right click, format cells, and then we can go currency, check it's all okay, and then press okay. All right, so we'll say we're going to buy 100 sweets to sell, 100 drinks, 100 crisps, and maybe 50 programs. Okay, now you can probably figure this out yourselves, but we've got to figure out how much this is going to cost. So we have to do that times that. Okay, so I'll just do that quickly. So this is cost of the theatre, and then I'm going to autofill everything down there. Okay, so what we can then do is, as we've done before, we can then get a total of how much everything is going to cost. So in the formulas bar, auto sum. So that's the money we're paying out as the theatre, and this is the money we're receiving. Okay. Now, one more thing we can do is we've obviously bought, say, 100 sweets. Now, it's going to be impossible to sell more than 100 sweets, okay, because we've only bought 100. We can't sell more than 100. So to help us out, we can add some what we call validation to the spreadsheet. So a bit like we did in the first seating bit, which kind of prevents errors by giving us a drop down rather than getting the user to type something in, what we can do is we can put some validation on the sweets box so it doesn't go over 100. Okay, so we can do this by clicking in the cell, and then just up in the search bar we can search for validation. Okay, and then on the drop down we can say whole number, and we don't want it less than 101. Okay, so it's got to be less than 101. So 100 would be okay, anything below 100 would be okay, but 101, because we've only bought 100 sweets, then we can't sell more than 100. Okay, so if I do okay, and then if accidentally I was typing in a value here, and say my finger slipped, I went to that, it's going to give us a message saying you can't put in that amount. Okay, so then we can put it back down to 100 should be okay, or whatever value we had before. Okay, so have a go at validating the numbers for drinks, crisps, and programs as well. Okay, to prevent the user from going over the amount that we've bought in the first place. Okay, so once you've done that, you should have a working seating, sales, and costs sheet. I'm just actually going to write total there, so we can tidy that up with the borders again. Okay.